We don't criticize. We don't gossip. We lift each other and strengthen each other so that we together will go through these circumstances and become stronger. Let me finish this. It says here, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. The rod and the staff are the tools of the shepherd. One is to guide and to move and to direct, and the other is to protect. Your rod and your staff comfort me. It's Christ or the Holy Spirit that is beside you guys. It's the Spirit of God that walks with you. Verse 5 says, you prepare a table before me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all through the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. He starts out in turmoil. He starts out in the valley of the darkness. He says, no, I will keep moving forward because I know I got God. And as long as I got God, we're going to make it. Church, as long as you remember and focus on God first, you're going to make it. We're going to help each other. We're going to invite people to come to church. Come see what we got, man. Come see what we got. We got room. Please. Talk about for the glory of God. Everything is for the glory of God. That's all God wants. He just wants to be glorified. That means that he's number one. That means that he is worshipped. That means that he is before everything. It's God first. Watch what it says in 1 Peter. We'll talk about the difficulties we go through. Why? And how different some circumstances are compared to others. And what circumstances would be better for us. Shall we? First Peter says what?
Who?
Say it again.
Who?
Who is going to harm you, church? If you are eager to be
good.
Start again. Who is going to harm you if you are eager to do good? But even if you should
suffer.
Amen? Even though you do something and you do it for the right reasons and the right thing and you get hurt, you get beat up, I remember, I'll save the day. And then there's a lady and a man in a car and she's screaming, hey, baby! I had the babies all this big. I outside Bobby's family, put the baby down, I come right into the car and I grab the car and I grab this guy who's on top of this girl. Grab the fuel like that, the girl jumped on me. What are you doing to my boy? Be careful who you help, man. They both turned on me trying to dribble me down the road. I'm all scratched up like, you know. Be careful who you're helping. Even if you're doing the right thing, you get hurt for the right reasons, it's a good thing. Who's going to harm you if you're eager to be good? But even if you should suffer for what is right, you are
blessed.
It says, do
not
fear their threats. Do not
be frightened.
You got a theme here? Huh? But in your
hearts,
revere Christ
as Lord.
Always be
prepared
to give an answer to
everyone who asks you.
To give the reason for the
hope.
And for the hope that you
have.
But do this with
gentleness
and
respect.
You just don't go up there and say, you're going to hell. Maybe they are. But that ain't going to do them no good, ain't going to do you no good. But they say, well, what church do you go to?
Glad, yeah.
Come and see. That's what I always say. I can explain this, but come see for yourself. You have to come see for yourself.
I did.
You did. A couple times. Stick around, didn't you? This little one here, she practically grew up in the last 10 years here in this church with her mom. We've seen this with 400 people in here, we've seen it with 10. But every time, every single one of them got some Jesus. You guys got me, have nothing to be afraid of. Do not fear the threats. Do not be frightened. But in your hearts, revere Christ as Lord, and you remember, and you worship the God that lives in you. Nothing matters. Nothing can get in your way. Nothing can slow you down. Nothing can stop you from struggling. Always, always, when you're focusing, the Word of God will always bring you back to where you belong. We'll see, Mama. Thank you, son. Thank you, good man. Always be prepared, because what have I told you, church, over and over again? There's something different about you. There's something in your eyes. There's a twinkle. There's a glow about you. There's something new in your life. What is it? Are you ready to tell them? Are you ready to tell them that it's Jesus Christ? Are you telling them that you got baptized? Are you ready to explain it? Sometimes all you can say is, you just got to come see me. Got to come to the church and see it. It's like nothing you've ever seen before, felt before, known before. Found out, and guess what? God is real. Amen? She says, but do this with gentleness and respect. Now, we're not here to persecute anybody. We're here to show the love of God, to welcome them. Open them doors, say, come on. You want some?
Come on, sir. That's all.
Now, look at it. We've got to work our lives, and we got to make our choices, and we got to make our decisions to glorify God. Look what it says here. But do this with gentleness and respect, keeping a so that those who speak maliciously against your good behavior in Christ Church
may be ashamed
of their
slander.
They can talk all day about Pastor Larry this, Pastor Larry that, but when it hits the road, when Pastor Larry shows up, you get the real deal. You get the only deal. There's no game. There's no facade. I'm not here to do anything but give God the glory, and you know that. Wherever room I walk into, the presence of God is going to be there, because I carry God with me.
Amen.
And the circles that I sit in, that God has brought me to sit in, and they all ask me. The mayor, the city councilman, the leaders of COVID, all these other behavioral places, they come around, and all of a sudden, because Pastor Larry's at the table, they start talking about their church. Captain David Neary, the head of counter-narcotics. Oh, I go to Grace Community Church. I go, I know your pastor, I know. As soon as you let God in the room, everybody starts talking about God. So when you carry God on your job, in the store, driving down the road, let Christ be the center of your thoughts. You know, have no drama, no worries. You have a clear conscience so that those who speak bad about you can't prove it. You go, you really think about Larry like that? Everything I've seen, Larry is loving and caring, and you open the doors, and you know. Except at home, of course. Then I'm a rotten lady man. I'll take care of the dog and everything. Keep a clear conscience. Make good choices. Do what you need to do. Verse 17 says, "For it is better if it is
God's will
to suffer for doing
good
than for doing
evil."
Amen.
You got that? You're gonna suffer, but it's better to suffer and work out and be prepared for that game and suffer through what you got to learn. You got to suffer by going to those Bible studies. You suffer by reading the Bible. You make that effort so that you're stronger and prepared for the circumstances when the evil comes up, temptation comes up, or just an opportunity to share comes up. You're ready. I'm a believer. Jesus Christ changed my life. I belong to this S.O.B.E.R. project. Once I've done, get some. Glad you asked. X marks the spot. I am not anonymous. I'm transparent.
Amen.
Only God can change a man like me. Sitting here for his work. There's got to be a God. I thought for sure I get a loud amen from over here. It's everywhere, you guys. God is at work, and God is preparing and getting ready the us. The lost. The us. Those that are coming out of the whorehouses, out of the crack houses. Those that are coming up out of prisons, out of detoxes. Those of us that are coming off the streets, coming out of the ghetto, into the light, looking For once you were out there looking for this. You were out there wondering what God's going to do. Where is God? And somebody said, you got to come to the S.O.B.E.R. project. You got to come and see what this is about. Because God shows up at that place. And you need God to change your life.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Verse 18. For
Christ
also
suffered
once for
sins,
the
righteous
for the
unrighteous.
Christ is the righteous, and we are the unrighteous. We should be on that cross. We should pay for our sins. But God said, no. I just happen to love these people I created. Thank you very much, he says. And I want you, 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 I want you. I want you, I want you. I want you. He wants you. He wants you. He wants you to fall in love with him. He wants you to give your life and your heart to him. He wants to pour into your life. He wants to be your God. He says, give me a chance. Just give me a chance. He suffered for the righteous. The righteous has suffered for the unrighteous. It says, to bring you to
God.
He did all of this so that at the beginning of this service, we can pray to God, ask for our sins to be forgiven, and now be in the presence of God. Because we've already sinned probably in our minds. We've already probably, the sin is going to be, it's just there, but we know it. We see it, we rebuke it, and we confess it, and we move forward. That's what God wants, the repentant heart. He says, he has put to
death
in the
body,
but made
alive
in the
spirit.
For Christ's body was sent to the tomb, but he had something else. That's right, empty tomb. Right, because he wasn't there no more. He walked out. Jesus! For Christ also suffered once for sins, for the righteous for the unrighteous, to bring you to God. He put to death in the body, but made alive in the spirit. Verse 19. After being
made alive,
he went and made
proclamation
to the
imprisoned spirits.
When Christ took his last breath, and they moved him into the tombs, and for 3 days, we don't know how long this took, but Jesus went to the gates of hell, took the keys of righteousness, opened up the keys, kicked out the door, and said, if you want some,
come get some.
Here comes Moses, here comes Noah, here comes all the saints of the Old Testament, come ripping and roaring straight out, and God takes them up, puts them in a place set aside for the Old Testament saints. Watch. Sorry. After being made alive, after Christ being made alive in his spirit, he went and made a proclamation to the imprisoned spirit, to those who were
disobedient
long ago when in the days of
Noah.
Well, the ark was being built, in it only a
few people.
Eight in all.
We're saved
in
the
water. So that water, all that water did is save eight people. But what about the water of baptism? What about the water of Christ? What about the blood of Christ that has changed the world, has changed the nations, that brought us into a complete reconciling to God? Where God said, the rest of the world, and you stay. They did it in Sodom. They did it in Gomorrah. Find me somebody righteous. They found eight people in the whole world at that time. Put them on a boat and started over. And here we are. God is for reals, for reals. That's as ghetto as I can get, guys. And that's the best way to get it. I can't get it much more ghetto. For reals, for reals. And he loves you, man. For us, for us. God is for us. I mean, he ain't no joke, man. there's a great video of the guys in the corner. On the video, they're talking about how, you know, I used to make fun of the Christians. I used to make fun of you guys, and now I am one of you. God's will, God's will. And our generation, this generation, just, we need to know this, we need to share this. I want them all in here, man. I want them all in here. Because God is real. Watch what it says here. And this water that we talked about in Noah's time, and this water symbolizes
baptism.
And now saves
you also.
Not the
removal of dirt
from the
body,
but the
flesh
of a
clear conscience
for
God.
That's what gets you from A to B, knowing that you're okay with God. We cool, God? We cool? Yeah, we're cool. Good. I'm there. I can make my move. Here's my bid, God. Here's my bid for this job, Pete. Here's this, is this good, God? Is this good for you? Yeah, good. We take care of business. We go to work. We check in with God. God will reveal to you exactly what to do. Water symbolizes baptism, and now saves you also, but not by the removal of dirt in the body, but now you have the pledge of a cleansed conscience towards God. Church, it saves
you
by the resurrection of
Jesus Christ,
who has
gone.
Watch, listen to this. Who has
gone
into
heaven
and is at
God's right hand.
Who are we talking about?
Jesus.
Say it again.
Jesus.
Jesus is sitting at the right hand, God's right hand, with
angels, authority,
and
powers
in submission to
him.
God. The angels can't stop singing, holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. God's good. Amen. God is good. Put your hands together. And this world is, this flesh and bone, this world is scratches and beat up and sickness and hurts and pains. It's just part of the body. I'd rather be hurting and in stretch for the glory of God than for being stupid. I don't want to be stupid. I don't want to pick up a charge for being stupid. I want to be right with God so I know what I'm doing. I'm making good choices. Because I have Jesus in my heart. But if you don't have Jesus in your heart, if you're not in a personal relationship with Him, this is where it's time. I say all that I've said so that I can say this. If you're here today, and you've not asked Christ into your heart, but you feel the presence of God, you feel God tugging at your heart. It's will. And He wants you to walk up here with me. He wants you to walk up here and proclaim your love for Him. And this is where we truly mean it when we say, if you want some,
come get some.
Come on, church. You may be afraid. It's okay, man. This is between you as individuals. No, this is between you and God. It's just between you and God. But you know what? You might not have another chance. Ask yourself, am I going to heaven? Am I going to hell? Do I know? Do you care? I hope you care. I care. I care. I want to go to heaven. So if you've not done this, I'll tell you right now, last call. Last call. Maybe somebody who's a believer just wants to just get back right with God. Maybe somebody just needs to come up here and just confess their sins. Just get right with God, man. It's just time to get right with God. There we go. All right, folks, come on. Anybody else just wants to just a little prayer? Ouch. And if you're here and you see these yellow cards, if you have any prayer requests, please fill these out and put them in the box in the back, and we will pray over all of your prayer requests. Anybody else that just wants to get right, confess their sins. You're a believer?
Yes, sir.
Okay, give your life to Christ.
I'm
you know, you're a mess.
Straight a little.
Yeah, you're a mess. You're being Jesus. You're right with God. All right, I'm sorry.
God.
I'm so sorry.
I'm so sorry.
You're in my way.
my way.
I know better.
But now I also know.
There's a place.
For me to learn.
And to grow in you.
So Lord Jesus.
Give me insight.
About you.
Show me.
Show me.
How to show others.
How to show others.
Your love.
Your patience. And your towers.
Use me, Lord.
Use me, Lord. For your glory.
I'm so sorry.
I'm so sorry.
Forgive all my sins.
Forgive all my sins.
All my past sins.
All my past sins.
All my present sins.
All my present sins.
All my future sins.
All my future sins.
Daily, Lord.
Daily, Lord.
I will repent.
I will repent.
And call you God.
And call you God. Amen.
Time player here. Karen and Juliana. What?
Minister.
Okay, get her back in. What's my mind?
Oh,